I'm here interviewing Walt Whitman. Tell us a little bit about yourself, Walt.
Okay, Walt, tell us about your early life.
Well, I was born May 31st, 1819 in Long Island, New York. And I was named after my father, but my name was unofficially shortened to Walt, just because it goes better with my personality.
So Walt, why was your writing so controversial in Leaves of Grass, along with the rest of your poems and books?
It was very controversial because of the heinous sexual content in it.
Walt, what was your writing mainly focused on?
In essence, I wrote about freedom. Freedom for the individual, freedom for the American, freedom for all races. I also wrote about my controversial sexual actions and beliefs, and my painful war memories.
So Walt, tell us a little bit about your writing about the freedom of individual Americans.
Well, I believe that all Americans and all American citizens should believe in two things. One, individualism. Two, democracy. And as a former school teacher, I'm very good at communicating and expressing my ideas to young people. I've definitely had a really big impact on America.
In Song of Myself, one of Whitman's poems from Leaves of Grass, he uses I not to represent himself, but the voice of all American citizens. He uses the quote, "What is commonest and cheapest is nearest and easiest to me." He's representing in that line that Whitman cares about the average American, and it's easy for them to connect to his writing, which made it more interesting and popular, although controversial. He also talks about how he tries to help the African American slaves when most white Americans would push them away.
Slave, come up here, I want to help you. I have water and food and shelter.
So Walt, now tell us a little bit about what inspired you to write the poem Song of Myself.
I just wanted to get my point across to the majority of America that I don't think anybody should be judged for their religion, their race, their class, or how they believe or think.
If you couldn't understand what I was saying, another point I was trying to make was that Walt Whitman also wrote about explicit sexual content in some of his poems that was very controversial. Walt, tell us a little about your infamous Calamus poems.
Well, my Calamus poem volume was the most provocative volume of poetry that I've ever produced. Some people have learned to call it the manly love of camarades. These Calamus poems made people believe that I was either homosexual or bisexual. The world may never know.
Rumors about Walt Whitman's homosexuality always seemed to float around, but they were not confirmed until after his passing. Most people think he was either homosexual or bisexual. Whitman was a battlefield nurse during the Civil War, and these rumors affected his job. He was fired because he wrote about obscene things. Once this information was released, it was typical for people to call Whitman trashy and profane, and a pretentious A. At a young age, Walt Whitman had a love interest in a man named Bill. He described their relationship as thick, and open sexuality that was not heterosexual was very frowned upon in this time period. Can you read us a part from one of your Calamus poems that indicates your homosexuality?
Sure. When he whom I love travels with me, or sits a long while holding me by the hand, when the subtle air, the impalpable, the sense that words and reasons hold not surround us and pervade us, when I am charged with untold and untellable wisdom, I am silent. I require nothing farther. I cannot answer the question of appearances or that of identity beyond the grave, but I walk or sit indifferent. I am satisfied. He who hold of my hand has completely satisfied me.
Here's a clip from Walt Whitman, circa 1902, expressing his homosexuality views.
Wow, Bill, I really like your flannel shirt.
Although many people did not know this, Walt Whitman had a close connection to the Civil War. He had terrible war memories. He just wanted peace in the world. Walt Whitman had a brother, George, who fought in the war, and he went MIA. Walt was incredibly close with his brother and felt the need to find him. Walt soon discovered that George Whitman was captured by Confederate soldiers. Walt Whitman's horrible war memories got worse. As a battlefield nurse, he saw many bloody, gruesome things, such as amputees. He couldn't get these memories out of his head and eventually developed PTSD, or post-traumatic stress disorder. The soldiers that Whitman was constantly surrounded by made him go into depression. Walt Whitman's depression was so terrible that he decided he needed to relocate. He soon moved to New York, where he began working on a very famous piece known as Beat Beat Drums.
Would the talkers be talking? Would the singers attempt to sing? Would the lawyer rise in the court to state his case before the judge? Then rattle quicker, heavier drums, you bugers wilder blow.
Walt Whitman's poem Beat Beat Drums was written to describe his painful war memories and how people should be more concerned about the war. He had seen many horrific things while there, and he wanted the average American to know how dangerous and gruesome it was in the Civil War. Here we will show you an example of Walt Whitman being a battlefield nurse and some of his gruesome memories. Oh my god, your leg! Oh, let me fix it. Oh, it's so horrific.
I need help still.
All in all, Walt Whitman wrote about the individual of Americans and slaves, his possible homosexual interests, and his painful memories as a battlefield nurse. Walt Whitman as a battlefield nurse, he saw many people with missing limbs and amputees. That was the same exact thing. Why did I say that twice?
I was just trying to get across to the majority of America that nobody should be judged for their weight.
So,
incredibly controversial because of the heinous sexual content. In conclusion, as the best thing that ever happened to America, and American literature for that matter, but mostly America.